That was the first question I asked when I was a little boy and my mother first told me about Satan. Because even after listening to all the Christian excuses trying to justify this guy, he is still the most unbelievable one-dimensional character I've ever heard of. Christians have not thought this through. Just look. Do you really think there's a devil that's been around for thousands of years and he's never read that book? And it's about him? Do they really think that if there is a devil, that the devil wouldn't have to know way more about all of this than every Christian? Which makes me think, there may well be a Lord of lies, and I have the evidence to prove it. Because if there was an inherent evil, such as everyone wants to believe, it would have to gather followers in order to bring in the tithe. And it would rule with the stick and the carrot, with impossible promises that can't be fulfilled, weighed against the threat of a fate worse than death for all those who didn't believe. And heresy would be damnable too. If there was a church of evil, it would be judgmental and prohibitive, inhibiting the natural drives of all its now dysfunctional devotees, and would be manned by prejudiced and paranoid reactionaries perpetually persecuting others while pretending to be persecuted themselves. And allowing no deviation from its mandates, the Lord of Lies would strictly restrict all forms of learning. Books would be burnt, curiosity crushed, and science attacked above all amid a perpetual war against every other religious denomination. And it would vanity, jealousy, vengeance, and wrath would be the monikers of an evil deity, and this is the worst ever. It would force believers to submit to unreasonable conditions. It would order crusades, initiate inquisitions, and lead villagers on witch hunts. It would protect and promote or permit child abusers and molesters seeking genital mutilation. And it would manipulate the masses only to oppress them. Each of the atrocities ordered by God in the Bible is more demonic than divine. Don't give in to the lesser of two evils. Reject both. In an educated civilization where civility is based on humanity as opposed to superstition and fear, the concepts of God and the devil are superfluous. Y'all know who this girl is? Look at this child. Is this the face of a demon? Or is this the look of a skeptic who's not buying your bullshit? The problem is, it's the same glare either way. And that's why we're lumped in together. This is the way we look when we realize we're being lied to. When you realize that all of the fables in the Bible began in the hearts of superstitious primitives who just made it up. It's man-made mythology, and there is no truth in it. There's no heaven, no hell, no Eden either, and there is no devil. He was invented by Persians, adapted by Jews, and embellished by Christians. He was never the serpent, nor a fallen angel, and he can't steal your soul because we don't have souls. Exorcism isn't real. Because demons aren't real. Because magic isn't real. We are not cursed. We are not fallen. We have arisen and we don't need salvation because God literally doesn't give a damn what happens after you die. Because then, neither of you exist. There is no goddamn devil because there is no God. Damn! You just die, and that's it. You're not immortal. You're not eternal. And to believe otherwise is to diminish everything that you really have. Life is precious because it is short, and there's nothing after it. There's no destiny, and there's no purpose beyond what you give it yourself. If you want your life to mean something, try making someone else's life meaningful.